Hi guys, welcome to another stream. Today I am going to be working on this painting that I started a week or two ago, and I've got these nice bright paints now, so I can try those out and hopefully get a really good painting with those. So I'm just going to check the sound and then get going. I've got my Chromebook set up, so if you've got any questions for me, you can type them in the chat box. Excellent. Right. Let's let people know we're here and then we can get painting. Right, I'm all set up, so let's get going. Right, so I left the painting, as you can see, as it was, because I really wasn't pleased with the colours. I didn't feel like they were vibrant enough. So I picked out these ones. They're not quite neons, but they're really bright. So I'm gonna test those out. I really can't wait to do the orange for Nemo, because I think he'll stand out a lot better. And I might actually change the position of this coral because it's in a bit of a weird place. So maybe I'll do Nemo first and then do the other bits around him. And I might change that background completely. My plan was that I was going to add some like grass as well on there, so that it would give it another colour. But we shall see. So I'm going to start with this one. It's going to be nice and bright. This one's called Pumpkin, so perfect colour for my little Nemo. I think I'm going to use a small brush to begin with and see how this comes out. I'm not sure how strong or whether this is going to be like an opaque orange or more of a transparent one, so we'll see, and that will determine how much layers we need to do. Well, it's a much better orange. I actually mixed the other orange and I really just wasn't pleased with it. I couldn't get it how I wanted it at all. So this is perfect. Just the right colour. I mean, sea life stuff's so vibrant, you really need to have the right colours to paint it. Yay! I think I'll do at least two coats to cover up the old colour and make this look really good. That's much better already. Yay! Looking forward to getting the black and the white on there a bit more. That'll really bring it out for sure. Thank you. Hopefully you can see what I'm doing okay. I couldn't zoom in on the webcam and I can't get the camera any closer. So hopefully you can see what I'm doing okay. I might go for a... I don't know, the background's really tricky. I'm not used to doing sea life painting, so I want to try and get it the best I can. It looks a much better colour, yay! I reckon these bright colours will look really great on my new slate hanging hearts. I'm going to have a go with those. If I finish this painting on stream, then I might start one of those if I've got time. We'll see how we go. So what we're going to do with this background then, I don't know what... There wasn't a blue in the set that I ordered, so I'm not really sure. I know I want to do pink. Maybe I should make this coral smaller. See what happens if I cover the top half up. So I want Nemo to really stand out. So I use this Flox Blue. Let's see if I cover that up, if that helps things. Definitely stand out more. I don't know whether I just need to move this entirely. Looking at the camera to see, get a better idea. Could look down there. I don't know. Let me have a look at my reference picture, which I've got on here. I could do like rocks behind him. My reference picture's got lots of rocks on. Do a rock instead and then do some greenery. I really want to do pink though. Maybe I'll just do it a bit smaller. I might end up changing the background altogether. Well, I've got a purple now, but I don't know if I'd like to have that whole thing purple. I don't think that would work for my usual colour palette. Maybe I'll put a sticky up a bit there and a bit there. Let's have a go with the pink and see how we get on. I could add some rock down here as well and do that kind of white. I don't want to overcrowd it, so. I'm just trying to keep it quite simple with just a coral on here, but I think I might need to tweak it a little bit. So let's try this and see how we go. This is lush pink. I'm gonna see what this comes out like. Looks quite pretty. Ooh. It's like a kind of raspberry pink to me. Hi to anyone who's just popping in. I'm working on this Nemo painting that I've started, and I'm just trying to get the colours right that I want. Just got these new paints, so trying to make it a little more vibrant. If you've got any questions for me or comments, please feel free to leave them in the chat box. I think maybe I will do some rock because I think it needs something to break it up a bit. And do that behind the coral. Yeah, I think that looks better smaller. Go ahead and do some rock. I think I'm going to start off by doing it white and then add in some like grey and some green, some like moss on it. I don't want to put too much detail in it and overpower it all because my style is quite simple, so it's getting the balance right is the tough thing, but experimentation is the idea. So I'm going to start it up here. I've got the inspiration for this painting from, we went to Glasgow last month, and we went to the Sea Life Centre there and saw this gorgeous tank of Nemos and Dories, and it was just so bright and vibrant, pretty. Got lots of photos of them, and really wanted to paint them, as I've not done any sea life paintings before. I thought it'd be really fun. So here we are. Be careful around the pink here so I don't get any on there in case it's still wet. I need my smaller brush for that area. I think I'm gonna bring that down here. My small brush. Gonna need to build up a few layers to get the white right, and then I can add in the grey. The reference picture I've got's got like moss sort of growing all over it, and it's got sort of grey. I've got little nooks in it for little creatures to get into. So try and convey some of that. I might bring that up a little higher. Still don't really think that's gonna work. This is really difficult. I think I need to keep it simple. Let's get on with Nemo and then decide what to do. Maybe I should have just left it blue. Maybe I should do the sea a nice bright blue instead, and then have the vibrant colours for the coral as well. Maybe it's the blue that's throwing me off. Hmm. what I think I'm going to do is cover it back up with blue, all solid blue, and then I think I'm going to do some like distress techniques for the background, and then so I might paint over the whole lot and start over with the coral and see what looks best. I think that's a good idea. I think I've over crowded it and it's not working. I could even add the bright colours into the distressed background actually. That would look pretty cool. And make Nemo the feature. Maybe I'll do that. I need to build up a few layers of this first. Doesn't matter if I go over Nemo a bit because I can paint him back in afterwards. Okay, so it looks kind of weird now. Hi, Si! You've got loads to be doing and should be streaming too. Oh, thanks so much for popping in. You can see that I'm having quite the adventure with this painting, trying to decide what to do with it, but it shall evolve, I'm sure. So I'll let that blue dry for a minute and have my cup of tea. And then I'm going to build up another layer and then add in some of the bright colours. So. If you can hear my dog bark in that sky, she barks at any little sound outside. She's a great guard dog. Decisions. I might do some like little coral along the bottom. Do the distress thing and then do some little corals. Maybe that would work better. And a few grasses up. So I feel like it'd be too plain if it was just a distress background and Nemo, so yeah, perhaps I'll do something like that. I'm going to use my trusty heat gun to help dry this off a bit quicker.
Thank you.
Yeah, I won't do any more blue. I think I'm gonna put in some white. And use my cloth to rub it in. Find a kind of a soft patch on here. It's getting a bit rugged now. I need to probably replace it. I'm just going to rub that in, and that will pick up all the textures from the paint that's been there already underneath. You can see the pink coming through already. And then I covered up that coral. Dampening it down. Rub that in some more. See, this is where it works to your advantage if you've messed up and you've put colours underneath. Because when you do the rustic kind of background, they all start to peep through, which is quite nice. I'm going to actually add some more in a minute. But that certainly helps. Now I'm going to add in some pink and I might put in a bit more of that blue. And some splashes of colour. So I'm going to rub that in. Paint is still quite wet underneath, so it's kind of helping it to blend in and sort of provide kind of a scratchy sort of effect. So I've got the light blue coming through already, which is really good, and I've got the pink coming through. I think we need some green. I've already got one of these open, so let's pop a bit of that in as well. Bit, not so much of the green, maybe a bit more down the bottom there. Oh yeah, this is working really well. This is coming out much better than what I expected. Love the colour of the coral that was to the right. I hope it comes back. Oh, yes, peeping through. I've got some Jimmy the Pink. I could pop a bit of that in. It's this one, it's a light portrait pink. I can have some of that going on. I think actually I'm going to build this up and work these colours. I think that works a lot better actually than painting the coral and then have the Nemo really stand out. So I'll show you guys in a minute. So kind of got the suggestion of coral. That's working really well. And a little bit of this orange. See, if you're playing around, you get there in the end. So, let's rub that in. Pick a nice bit of rag. down too much. There. And I think I'm going to add in a bit more white. Quick it dries when it's thin. I have to wash that down a bit more. So I'll get around the edge a bit of Nemo. Show you a bit closer up and try and get it right. There we go. The light's making it look a bit funny, but you can see all the colours coming through. So I think I'll give that a blast. Bit more of the light blue, which was one down here. This is an Amsterdam acrylic paint, and the colour is sky blue light. So I'm going to pop a bit of that in and break this red up a bit. Got lots of colours coming through now. Right, I'm going to work on Nemo for a bit now. I'm going to do another layer of the orange. I feel like I need to lighten up the whole thing. really like all the colours peeping through, but I still feel like it's too dark. For my style, I feel like it's a bit too different. So I am going to go ahead and add in some highlights and shading. So I'm going to have the light source coming on this side. So I'm going to get some, which colour should I use? I think I'll use my trusty brown. I only need a little anyway. Dark on the up a little. Done black yet on him on purpose because I don't want to mess my water up, so I'm going to wait and do that at the end. So just blending out that shading. Gives them a bit more depth once you start adding in the highlights and shading. Now we'll go in with some white. Put it on his tail there. Some here. Some more here. How that's a bit rough actually, so I think I'm going to leave it like that and give it a blast. Welcome to those of you who have joined us. I'm kind of going on a bit of a journey with this painting as I'm new to doing sea life things. So it's quite fun. So I really want to lighten up the background. The Nemo blends in a lot more now. It's looking quite good. I think I just want to lighten it up a little more. So I think I'm going to go in with this guy, light blue. And make it a lot brighter. We might need some more white as well. Thank you. think I'm going to have a lot of white around the edge to brighten it up. Now it's starting to look more like my style. That's it. Cool. Is a bit more. That's it. Some of the darker blue back out. So I'm pretty pleased how this is going so far now. As you can see, I've lightened it up a lot. But you still see the nice bright colours peeping through. Gives it a lot more depth and texture. So I'm going to blast that with the heat gun and then work some more on Nemo. My reference picture up on the computer so I can see his detail. Right, so I'm gonna need my little brush and my white. So I'm gonna freshen up those areas where I went over and where it should be white. Markings, right? Gonna need to build up another layer of white on this one. And I've got some here. A tiny little bit of white on the edge of his tail. Just a tiny bit. put in some little bits of grass coming up with green, but I'm going to kind of blur it out, so make it not show too much. Another layer of the white, and I think I'm going to use Titan Buff to blend it out a little, if I can find my Titan Buff. Away the brightness of the white too much, but be good to get some shading on there. Looks like I need to blend that in a little bit more with some orange. Just a tiny bit. Where his lips are lighter than the rest of his face. And then I'll add in a teeny bit of white. Okie doke. Now we need to do his eye and the black bits of his features. So I'm going to find my black right here. Finish my tea before it gets cold. So let me put my reference pick down so I can see what the camera is showing. Right, so this is what we've got so far. You can see all the different colours showing through. So I'm pretty pleased with that so far. Put the reference pick back up. Right, let's do the black. I think I'm going to start with his eye, which is quite close to the white band that we've got here. It's quite big. Got a little stripe that comes down there and gets a bit thicker here. A little bit of black on his little fin down here, and then he's got some black here on his other fin, and I probably need to blend that out because it's quite, it's a bit transparent. Scoop that out in the brush. And then there's like a faint black line across there. Let's put that in. Thank you. in here. Once the lines are in place, I'm going to go over them with a wetter brush so that I can smooth out the lines and just get a nice finish on it. I'm going to do his tail and his crop. Okay, let's give that a blast. I think we need some touch-ups of orange and white. Some white for the highlight in his eye. Thank you. Okay, bring that out a little bit. Alright. So, seeing if there's anything else I want to add. Which I don't think so. I think I'm going to start adding in some detail with my charcoal pencil next. What else did I want to do? I think I might add in some white around here. So I feel like he stands out a little bit too much. Whereas my reference photo, he kind of blends in with the background a little bit. I think maybe we do need something down here a little bit more, so I'm going to put in some blue coral, but I'm going to do it quite blurred like I did these. So. We go back and forth about this. That's better. That's better. So I'll need to do the edges and give that a varnish, but I call this one done. So a bit hard for you to see the detail, but I've done the grasses so that it looks like he's swimming through them now, so it's kind of more balanced. So pretty pleased with how that came out. So I hope you've enjoyed watching me paint this. Now I think I'm gonna go and get a slate heart and start working on that one. And I also need to change my water as well. So I'll be right back, guys. I'm back, guys. So gonna be working on this slate heart, and haven't decided yet what I'm gonna do on it. I was thinking like some cakey themed thing. You can see how well I plan this. So yeah, just thinking what I'd like to do. Like to do something a little bit different. I normally do cakes and teacups and things, and I kind of feel like breaking out of that a little bit and doing something a bit different. So It's always hard though, making the start if you're going to do something new. So, let's see. What shall we do? Be really nice to cover the whole of the slate heart, I think. And let's think. Also, compositionally, this is quite difficult because you've got the narrow sides, so you need to think where things can be positioned that will look really good. I'm kind of drifting away in my mind, thinking maybe something countryish instead, which would be cool. Thinking a little cottage. I know you guys can't see this right now, but I only roughly sketch out what I want to do anyway, so you'll be able to see very soon what it looks like when I lay the paint down. Maybe we should do some sheep. So I'm sketching out a little teacup, totally changed tack again. I just wasn't feeling the other one. It's gonna be too big. You know what I'm going to do? I am going to paint, I'm going to pick a colour, I'm going to paint the whole background, and then I'm going to sketch it. Because then by then I might have some ideas of what I really want to paint, because this is not coming together. Sometimes I can do this, I can sit down and know what to paint, and it just comes to me, and other times it's more difficult, especially if I don't have anything in mind ahead of time. So I'd really like to do pink on this because I think that's going to stand out so good against the slate. So I'm going to pick this tea pink. Can't really see it. There we go. And I went out for afternoon tea for a friend's birthday recently, so that's a bit of inspiration to go by. There was some lovely strawberries and scones, nice naughty things. I think I'm going to do a big cottage. Doesn't that look really pretty on the pink background? You see how I'm going back and forth between cottages and tea. I think a nice cottage with some daisies, that would look really cute. Got a good base. I probably need to go over it again and I need to tidy up the edges, but now I've got an idea of what I want to do, I can go ahead and sketch it in. So I'm gonna have a nice big cottage in the middle. I think I'm gonna do some like daisies. Just kind of big ones popping up here. Okay, not bigger than I expected. Maybe some little ones. We'll have a bit of a sunset going on behind. So I'm going to start off with the grass. I'd like to get that in first as it's a real contrast colour to the rest. Hang on, guys. I can hear Sky being naughty. I'll be right back. Right, that's her sorted out. Oh dear, the adventures of little Sky. Put her in a bed so she can behave herself for a little while. Welcome to those of you joining me. I'm now working, just finished up my Nemo inspired painting and gonna be working on this one, a little slate hanging heart. I think I'm gonna do this, well I am now, doing this Daisy Cottage. Wasn't sure at first what to paint, so finally decided what I wanted to do. If you've got any questions for me, feel free to put them in the chat box. Thank you. I'll let that dry and then I'll add in some shading and highlights to that nearer the end. So now I'm going to go in and work on the daisies. So I've got this gorgeous Naples yellow. Can't really see it that well, it's all sort of screwed up tube, but it's a Winsor & Newton Galleria brand. So I'm going to use that for the centre of the daisies, and I'll probably put a little bit of it in the sky as well when I finish the sky up to give it kind of a sunset feel. Let's do the white for the daisy petals now. I'm just doing the first layer, and sometimes second layer of all the elements of the painting first, before I put the detail in. Lots of petals on it. Nice pretty daisy. okie doke. Right, I think I'm going to go ahead and do some more on the background. So I'm going to do some more pink. This is quite a transparent pink. Other colours to brighten that up. I think I'm going to use this pink suede to add in a bit of depth. I don't want too much because it's quite a pretty pink. Just a touch. And then a little bit of the Naples yellow to kind of give it a bit of a sunsetty kind of feel to it. And kind of all pulls everything together, all the colours. I think I'm just going to go in and tidy up these edges now, the tea pink. And I'll give it a good dry. Paint off the edge there where I went over. Make it a bit neater. Right, so let's give it a blast and dry that off nicely. Okay. So let's do the cottage now. I'm going to need to start it with white. Do one more layer and then I'm going to do some shading with the Titan buff. So I'm going to have the light source coming in from the left, so I'll do the shadows on the right. Blend that out. And then we need to do the roof. So I'm going to do that in brown. Should need that again actually. To give this one a good shake because it's getting low. see it starting to come together a bit more now. So I think I'm going to go to half past. That's about another 10 minutes, guys. And got to give the dogs their dinner. So I should probably have to come back to this. Even though it's only a small painting, there's lots of detail to be put on here. And I don't want to rush it. Then I'm going to go in with the Titan buff before I paint on my arm for one. So this is the highlight, so it's going to go on the left side. White to make the highlight a bit stronger. Okie dokie. Right, now I think I'll do the grass. I shall need that for in a bit later. Right, I don't need that for now. I'll do a little heart probably on the cottage at the end. So let's go ahead and do the grass. I need one more coat of green and then some highlight and shadow. I'm not too worried if I go over the white because I can paint over that later. So now I'm going to go into, I think I'm going to use my bigger brush, and I'm going to go into the brown with quite a damp brush. I'm going to put in some shadow, like a path. Extend it out. And then I need some white. Dry that off because it's pretty wet. between the door and the windows for the cottage. Paint those in later. And then I think I'm going to add a little bit of white to the sky. I need to put in a bit of green there where I missed behind the daisies. Let's fill that in. Blending that white out with the damp brush. Give it a bit of a highlight. Dark brown. Not up there. There we go. This is my go-to brown for darker areas that I want to do, if I can open it. The lid is stuck. Let's see if I can get into it. Yay! Okie doke. Right, I need my small brush. Okay. So I think I'm going to stop there. I'll leave the daisies for another time because I'm going to need to do lots of detail on those. But that's not bad for a start. So here's what we've got. Still lots to do on there. But thanks so much for watching, guys. I hope you've enjoyed watching me paint. And don't forget to check out my YouTube channel, which is Niki Jackson Art. And you can see all my videos on there. And yeah, I'll catch you next time. Thanks again. Thanks so much for being here.